seemed that you had your first substitution about 75, 76 a minute, a little longer than usually in the past. Was that because of your two players who weren't here today to play, or was that just because of the flow of the game, people doing a good job?
It's really because I felt that we were in control of the game, so I didn't think there was a need to make the change. I was initially going to take Augie out the midfield and put Juan Pablo in there and then bring on another forward, but felt that we were pretty solid in the center of midfield, so I didn't want to upset that balance and run the risk of them finding a way through the middle of us. So that's why I didn't make the change. I rolled the dice by bringing two forwards on, so it was brave again, which I think, you know, myself and the coaching staff have been brave with our changes this year, and I was brave again, and it didn't work tonight. You know, I mean, it didn't hurt us, but you know, neither one of the forwards, they both had chances, but they didn't get on the end of them.
Yeah, I thought we were going to see history repeat itself, but for the positive for us tonight, that last minute, you were all over that net.
Yeah, all over. I mean, that's, you know, I was just telling them, let's put it in, and they were looking a bit shaky at the back, but it just didn't happen. It's frustrating because now I've got to go in the locker room and I've got to try and lift the guys up because they're going to feel like they've lost again, just as they did on Wednesday. They're going to feel like they've lost. But they have to take the positives. I mean, every game we've played in, we've probably been the better team. If you look, I would say St. Louis away, you know, they were the better team, but you know, it's to be expected on a long road trip like that. But all the other games that we've played, we've been the strongest team, and that's encouraging for the rest of the season.
Yeah, I would say from your trip to Seattle on out, you've really definitely been the stronger team, it seems to me.
Yeah, anyway. I mean, even the Vegas game, you know, you don't want to concede three goals at home, but I think overall we're the better team. If you look, you know, not a big stat guy, but if you look at the stats, we definitely were better in all departments, and, you know, had we had a bit longer on the clock, we would have come back and, you know, got a point out of that game as well. And then we'd be seven games unbeaten, but we've got to start turning now. Some of the focus is going to be about turning some of these draws into wins, and then we'll be in a very healthy position.
Well, thank you so much, Coach, and we always appreciate it. Thank you, guys.
Thanks a lot.
So tell us a little bit about the match itself.
Yeah, I mean, I think we had some very good chances to score. Defensively, I thought we were very solid, and they didn't really have that many chances. They might have a little bit more possession, probably pretty even, but I think overall we had better chances to score. I should have probably been on the score sheet myself, looking back at it, but you know, it goes on. At least we got the shutout and a point.
Yeah, another six games undefeated. Not a bad thing. It seemed early in the match that they were going to try to push through the middle of the pitch, and then they try to go through the perimeter, and then you guys would shut them down constantly.
Yeah, I mean, I think overall our communication and everything, we were very organized. Kept it very organized, compact, and just...
Is there a mental thing that happens when you are up a player because their player was given a red card, we have a few minutes left, or do you stay true to what you're doing?
Maybe in that case we try to just push the tempo a little bit more, go forward, maybe more direct, just get balls in the box and try to create another goal opportunity.
Excellent. Well, I want to thank you very much.
Thanks so much. You-